You've heard of unconditional love, but have you heard of the secret to unconditional happiness and allowing more into your life? More wealth, more success, and more love. More freedom in your life right now. Welcome to the Happy Bar with Israel Savage.
You know, I grew up with a practiced habit of thinking around fear. In other words, fearful. Thoughts that made me feel fearful. Another way to say that is I had a practiced habit of vibration, of feeling. But it all started with my thinking. And that's still something that I'm experiencing. I've learned, though, that fear isn't unwanted. It isn't a bad emotion. It's not something I should push against, because what you resist persists. We know that, right? We also know what you focus on, you make more of. So in many ways, fear is my friend. And what I mean by that is that fear is guidance. And so if I'm feeling a feeling that I might call fear, I know that I have thoughts that are not in harmony with what my greater self is thinking about any person, place, or thing. And so, for instance, if I think about a situation, oh, I don't want to try that because I might fail, my greater self wouldn't see it that way. My greater self would think thoughts about a new situation that go something like this. Oh, practice makes progress. And I know that I am not going to be good at this right away. And that's fantastic, because that means I'm stretching, I'm growing, I'm learning, and that's what life is all about. But one thing I know for sure, because I know me and I know how the universe works, I'm going to get better and better and better and better at this thing. And then one day I'm going to feel as if I have mastered this, and it will be time to try something new that stretches me in a different way. And I'm going to enjoy the process of becoming. I'm going to enjoy making progress in this area. That's how my greater self might see a situation. And when I'm feeling fear, what I'm really experiencing is the tension between the thoughts my physical self is thinking and the way my greater self might think about that situation. So recently I was feeling fears around finances, around lots of things, almost everything, around my own abilities, etc., etc., etc. And they seemed to come from nowhere. In other words, they didn't seem to be deep rooted. And so I was curious where they came from. You know, I was in this high-flying place, and then I would feel these fears. What I realized was it had everything to do with what I was taking into my mind. One of the things that I noticed was at night, I would watch a little CNN. And the news, it was full of fear. The news was full of people's fears about this and that and this and that. Fine to notice that for a second, but to allow myself to be inundated in the way that you are when you watch a news program, you know, especially a news channel, where the same story is told from 10 different perspectives in 10 different time slots. I love the media, and I'm part of the media, so. No hidden meaning there. But I do think the feeling that I was feeling, the thoughts I was thinking, felt a little slimy. But I didn't realize that. And I was doing my best to only watch the news when I was in my happy place. And so I'd be in a happy place and start watching. But inevitably, I would go to bed right after, and then I would wake up fearful. And it would be hard to shake these feelings of fear. And these would be, again, fears about many aspects in my life. What I realized is that I had this generalized fear, and that's how emotion works. Emotion isn't necessarily tied to a specific thing, even though our specific thoughts trigger it. Emotion is like water that's not contained in a glass. It can spill over all over the linen tablecloth and touch everything on the table. This emotion, this generalized fear that I was feeling, was precipitated by my thoughts, my focusing on other people's thoughts, to be more specific, about world events. I was focused with such intensity that there was emotion associated with that. I was empathizing with the situations I was seeing and the fears of others. And so, in essence, they became my fears and touched other areas of my life. The second that I changed what I watch, especially before I go to bed, and so I made the choice the next day not to watch any news. And in fact, right before bed, I listened to something that uplifted me, that made me feel prosperous, that made me associate and empathize with prosperity and with abundance and with happiness. I woke up feeling invincible. And if there were areas that I didn't quite feel invincible yet, it was much easier to get myself there in the morning. And so the good news and the bad news, but really it's only good news about emotion, is that it's generalizable. It's generalized. And so in the same way, now that I know that's a power that I have and that you have and that we have as human beings, I can choose where to put my focus. And by putting my focus on things that enable me easily to think good feeling thoughts, that emotion of abundance and prosperity will generalize into and spill over into other areas of my life and affect them all, one by one by one by one, until I am prosperity. Because you see, that is the truth. I am prosperity. I am abundance. The only thing that interrupts the acknowledgement of that, that stops me from embracing that, is my own resistance, is thoughts and that make me feel fearful or trigger disbelief or discouragement. This is really about allowing. This isn't about anything I have to do necessarily, although you could say it's up to me where I put my attention and focus, but is turning your head from one direction to another or turning the TV off really something that you have to do? Really has more to do with awareness, with an awareness of how I'm feeling and using that as my guide. Using the power that I have to place my focus on good feeling things, things that are easy for me to think good feeling thoughts about. That power makes all the difference. The power that we have to use emotion as our guide, to think a different thought by putting our attention somewhere that's better feeling. Try it. And watch as your life opens up for you. Really, your life is already open, but watch as you open up to meet it.
If you liked what you just heard, then take inspired action now. That's right, act while you are feeling good and build on your momentum. Schedule your free discovery call with me at instudios-nyc.com/happybar.